Now I like to invite Dr. T.P. Sashikumar, and his master Swami Rama was very close friend of Swami Bhuvaji Maharaj, and he may like to share some things.
Namaskaram to all of you and pranams to the great feeling which all of the great souls are sharing here on this day of remembering Swami Bhuvaji. Different aspects of a human, physical, he was very strong. He has demonstrated probably what others cannot do. Very rarely people get that flexibility. And not just that, I have seen him on video showing some of the activities. He showed that it is that not possible to do. And everybody says, yeah, maybe this old man will not be able to do that. And next moment, he will show that he is easily doing it. So he had that, as earlier somebody mentioned, that childlike activity, which makes people, yeah, you may feel it is difficult, but if you take another trial, you may be able to do it. That sort of feeling was given while demonstrating, while motivating people to do that. Again, most of the people who spoke, including Nalia and Lakshmiji and all that, all of them were talking about his emotional attachment. I think most of the Swamijis or people who are into social or who reach at higher levels of attainment, they feel that they have a cloud together, always moving, and they should not be serving somebody else. They deserve to be served. But here, we find a lot of examples where he cooked for others. He was happy in serving everybody. And that feeling of being together, the emotional attachment, that is what makes him probably most unique. The third intellectual, I heard that he could speak many languages. The way he showed in some of the audience, he never spoke even. Some people think that speaking is more important. But I've seen him in one of the podium where he was asking somebody else to hold his nose and his breath was stopped. And that continued for some time. So that shows, yes, you don't have to speak a lot about your abilities. You are practically to show. And I've seen him, his visits in different places where he was too tired physically, but people has fallen on his feet and then doing the pranams. And yes, he has shown all that intellectual ability to speak about many, recognize many. We don't know how many of them have that ability until the last breath. And no word to say that spiritually, that spiritual growth is what probably gave him the physical, emotional, intellectual, and social ability. The social ability, mixing with the people, remembering them, considering them, taking care of them, hand-holding them. I think when I got connected through Swami Rama, or maybe through Nadaraja Guru's Yeti, all that part of those people who had that lineage, I wish that is what now Dilip ji carries forward. And I'm so happy to be have that brotherly love from Dilip ji on having giving opportunity to speak to few of these programs. Through these programs, maybe some lineage from Swami Rama gave that qualification, but I'm sure that lineage which Dilip ji got from Swami Bhuva is what equipping many of these things happen. And that ability to reach up to the UN, when many of the people were not venturing to go to such places, and then taking that initiative, that is what made all of us to connect today. So pranams to all that tags, threads, probably the hooks in the chain which connected all of us together. Namaskaram and pranams to all of you. It is great to remember great people, but it's also more important to take some lessons from that and then try to see that we also carry forward that message. So I'm sure I cannot speak of Bhuva without mentioning Dilip ji, because though I heard from my guru's disciples about Bhuva, this opportunity gave me to learn. I'm only an academic learner of him, but I was able to connect very fast, because many such branches, as Naliya told, it was all from the seed, and we are in the same forest. We all have at least one small saplings in the forest which or where this is being grown. Namaskaram and pranams to all of you. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. That is wonderful to hear from your message. And I know Swami Rama used to do yearly program in America, and Swami Bhuva was invited so many times.
Yeah, Chicago was their normal meeting place.
And when you mention about Guru Nityadinyadi, that is, he is my relative, when he used to come to New York as a visiting professor in different universities and colleges, he used to stay at Swami Bhuva's place.
I think Swami Bhuvaji's breath was called circular breathing.
Correct.
So he was able to breathe continuously without a exhale and inhale process, which was evident, and he could continue for hours.
Hours, correct.
That was a very rare. And I have seen in some place where his conch was to be given to somebody, he was selecting the person to whom it is to be given. Somebody else was showing hand, he was not giving. So he found
that was Nilaya. That was in
Nilaya. So that's why when Nilaya was speaking, I was connecting that immediately. Yeah. And then see that.
I'll invite Dr. T.P. Shashi Kumar for a closing remarks and a prayer.
Namaskaram. It was great remembering one of the probably the richest contributor towards physical asana, plus getting into the spirituality, minute aspects, explaining to the West, popularizing, connecting, as many people did, but I don't know how many people did the interfaith activity along with that. So it was taking a tradition is one, spreading the tradition across different culture, religion, practice. That's why he must have traveled all across the globe. I'm sure a great tribute, a great remembrance, connecting many people, each other. We are all blessed being part of that, though most of us have not directly seen, but we are able to connect through the chain of the people who have connected to him directly. It is our responsibility to take this message forward. I think these sort of remembrance and events which are happening is to take an oath that we are here to take this forward. probably those influential people are those people who collected a lot of money and made their own institution under their name. But I am sure if Vivekananda was not there, Ramakrishna would not have known to the world. But here we have a Ramakrishna who was known to the world. But if, like Dilip ji, another Vivekananda was not here around, I am sure I would not have never got to know him so emotionally, spiritually close. We would not have, many of us would not have even connected without this string of nodes which are connecting all of us to that great inspiration, Bhuvaji. So we are all, on behalf of every person who spoke here, Dilip ji, we have to take this forward. We must do much more and take this message, because people take advantage of not getting institutionalized, and those people who get institutionalized are more popular, and people don't even mention the names. That's why you remember when the yoga day I was mentioning the picture of Mysore, where instantly you posted it. Similarly, people speak of different aspects without knowing, forgetting the root. Like today it was mentioned that the seed is more important, right? So we have a big forest, but we forget the seed. I'm sure we should all get to the
that
room.
Is a great say. Great say. That is a great say.
I think we need to get more closer, plan some activity, name some activities under him. He was one who was taking Bhagavad Gita message throughout his teachings. I saw some quotation which I mentioned today. I was posting it on Facebook as comments. He found that Bhagavad Gita is really a practical handbook. And I'm so happy Dilip ji is getting into such. It is not without a core knowledge subject getting propagated. It is not getting learned. It is not getting popularized. Otherwise, it becomes superficial sometime. I remember Swami Rama's mentioning sometime, I am not calling myself a yogacharya, but I found many people who take a 3-month certificate program under me are calling themselves as yogacharyas, right? So the world is with full of certification programs, titles, and we have somebody who may not have that much contribution, but they are good in marketing. So we only look at the cover, but not the inside. Discover is not done. So this is a great discovery of learning about Bhuva for many people, I'm sure. We should have such occasions to remember. More than that, that message should be taken. I think we all take that pledge that we are with you on this great travel. And I'm glad that today you are getting that, probably getting that, you know, when the office is open. That is one another ladder step going up. So we all look forward for that communication. Thank you, pranams to each one of you for being part of it. I'm so glad that I got this opportunity and blessings of associating with such great souls. Thank you, pranams.
Thank you. Dr. T.P. Sashumaraj is going to start the Bhagavad Gita class every Sunday, 10 a.m. to 12 p.m. New York time. Actually, 90 minutes is enough, but in case, I put it like 2 hours. And if any big events falling on those, any of the Sundays, we may change the date or we cancel that day. Only few events may come. So it seems like 22 Sundays are going to happen in this year. And rest of the information will give on the first day. I saw around 69 people register, and I know he's going to teach the real aspects of the philosophy rather than a politics. we do not need the politics. We need the spiritual core teaching. You know, he is good for that. I am 100% sure he will fulfill our mission with that. And we want people to learn it and live with it and propagate and teach. That's the purpose, nothing else. Otherwise, there's no point to have these type of events, you know. So we want to make sure everybody is part of our global community, value our community, whatever you feel, how you can help us in different ways.